Hey folks, in this video, you will see how to protect your Kubernetes cluster in just a few minutes. We will use CloudCasa for this. If you don't have an account, it's okay. Creating an account is free. Just fill out a short form at signup.cloudcasa.io and confirm your email address to start protecting your data. Okay, let's log into the application and start from the dashboard. To protect the cluster, first we need to register it. To do this, click on the Add Cluster button from the shortcuts on the right side. In the sidebar, select the type of agent to use. If your cluster isn't already running Valero, select No. Then enter the name to be used in CloudCasa, for example, My Cluster. Next, click Register. To connect the newly registered cluster to CloudCasa, we need to install an agent on it. Copy the generated command and execute it on a system with access to the cluster. Returning to the application, after a while we will receive information about installation success, and our cluster will change status to active. We can now create a backup. In the table, click on the cluster name, then select the Define Backup option. We have many advanced options, but let's focus on the simplest case, which is to make a full cluster backup. We can skip all these steps and go straight to Summary. Since we can run the backup task many times, we need to give it a name for reference. For instance, My Backup. Now click Create and Run, and we're done. We have to wait until our job is successful, and then our cluster will be safe. On the cluster dashboard, there are sections like Backups, Restores, Recovery Points, and Activity. To see our job, we click on the last one. Then we can click on the job name to see details. Depending on the amount of data the cluster contains, it will take more or less time. In our case, it just takes a few seconds because our cluster is small. This is our application, of which we made a backup. Let's imagine someone hacks into it, deletes all tasks, and adds new ones saying, "You were hacked." Refresh the page to make sure the previous data is gone. It's not there. Everything is lost. Fortunately, we have our backup. From Cluster Dashboard and the tab Recovery Points, we see a list of all of our recovery points for the cluster. Expand Actions and select Restore. Similar to backup, we have many options, but let's focus on the simplest case, which is to restore everything without any filtering or transforms. Go to Summary. Restore jobs are saved so that they can be rerun, so we need to give it a name. Let's use First Version. The click on Restore. We can also track all jobs from the dashboard. After a while, we see two successful jobs in the statistics, and in the Activity widget, our job changed status to Completed. This means our restore was successful. To be sure, let's go back to our demo application, and there's no trace of the hacking attack, thanks to CloudCasa.